Today I will be making this tool for opening this washer motor, as it is difficult to open the bolt of this washer's motor. After removing the motor, I will tell you how to test the hall sensor or the speed control sensor for these washers. I watched some videos where they told to open this motor. They said that the drum should be held from the front side by another person, and then the motor would be opened easily. Which is not the correct method. Owning the correct tool to open the direct drive washer motor is important. Otherwise, you will damage something while opening the motor. That's why I will make that tool I showed you at the start of the video. This DIY tool will be useful for a single person to open the motor easily. So for making the tool, you should have a thick gauge 90 degree iron bar. But if you have a lighter gauge of the angled steel bar, it will still make the work done. Other than this, a flat iron bar can also be used in making this tool, or you could also use an iron rod. This work will also be done using this rod. But the best is to use the 90 degree iron bar. Let me explain how this 90 degree iron bar is the best for making this tool when I will open the motor. So, through this hole in the motor. And I have to hold the motor through these holes with the tool. I will do its setting, as we have to apply torque on the bolt. And set the 90 degree iron bar according to these holes. Friends, different designs can be made for this purpose. If you can make it better than this, you can make one for yourself. This tool will not only be used for this washer, as it will be a universal type, which will be used for LG, Samsung, GE, Maytag, or any other washing machine motor. But if we work on Samsung and other brands, the distance of the holes can be different, but this universal tool can also be used for other brands. Now I will measure the hole size in them to prepare our tool. The hole size is 8.5 millimeters, and start making the tool according to this hole size. The length is 29 centimeters of the 90 degree iron bar, which I will use. You can increase or decrease the length of the bar, accordingly, but for the universal tool, increase the length of angles for the hole's capacity. Next, you will need three nuts. A rod or a large bolt. As I have these things available, I am using them. The nut should be free in the bolt. Next, you need two bolts in small sizes, and I will tell you further in the video what their use will be. Now I will drill holes on both ends of the angled iron bar. I already made a small hole on this end of the iron. Now I will drill a bigger hole. This is a 7 mm hole that I drilled. The bolt should go tightly in the cavity of the iron angle. Now I will fit this bolt in the hole I drilled. The bolt thread should be 3 to 4 mm inside the hole. Now with the help of a hammer, we will press the bolt. The gap is 5 mm, but I can decrease the gap as the thickness of the machine is less. But a 5 mm gap is also good. I will now weld the bolt. Now I will weld the next bolt as well. The length of the bolt should not be extended because it can cause damage to the motor. The purpose of welding these bolts is to grip the motor through them, as when we apply force, it would not come out easily from the motor. I will shape the bolts for this purpose. If this bolt grips from this side, the opposite bolt will grip from the opposite side of the second bolt. As you can see, I have completed the shaping process. This is the shape I have made. The same second bolt has a cut opposite to the first bolt. The bolt shape can also be flattened, but this design will not make the tool come out of the motor holes. Now I will fit it inside the holes of the motor. As one side of the steel bar is not equal to the second hole, I have to make space between them for the bolt opening. I am marking the distance to cut the iron bar to make it align with the second hole. Now I will mark this 90 degree iron bar and cut it. The width of the iron bar is 30 mm, so I have marked it at 30 mm. Now I will join this marking with the corner of the iron bar, which means I will cut it at 45 degrees and remove this portion of the iron bar. The same I will do with the other piece, cut it at 45 degrees. Both the pieces are ready, as I have cut them both. While cutting, I made a small mistake. Ensure to cut it from the front side of the bolts, as I had cut it from the other side. Now after drilling holes again, I have prepared it again. But you should avoid making this mistake to save time. Now I can bend them. Now we will weld the other parts I showed you earlier. You can see that I have held the bolt in the center. Now I will weld it with a smaller piece of the 90 degree iron bar. Now I will weld the next two bolts with the bigger 90 degree iron bar. The pieces are something like this after being welded. The details seem like this with single and double bolts. I have decreased the length of the bolt so that it can fix into the bolts like this. Now it is movable. Next, I will weld a rod on this side, which can hold the motor tightly in its place. Now I will weld the rod, but how, let me tell you. We will not weld it straight, but in a little twisted position so it may not touch the machine. Our tool is ready now. Let me show you each piece individually. I have put this small piece first in the hole. As you can see, I have welded the rod with this piece. Now I will put the bigger piece inside the hole of the motor. Now put the lock or pin inside the joints. Now it cannot fall apart because the hooks have locked it, and now it will be effortless to open the motor with the help of 17 number socket ratchet wrench. Now put the ratchet on the bolt and apply force to open it. Now it is effortless for a single person to open it without any issue. As you can see, I opened it effortlessly without any problem, and I don't need two people as I am enough to open it all alone. As you can see, I have opened it. Now remove the pin and the parts. As you know, they are locked, so you cannot remove them altogether. Now, this is opened, pull it slowly in an outward direction. Slowly and gradually, pull it outward because it has a magnet inside, so you must push in the outward direction. As you can see, I have opened it, and you can see the coil over here, and a Hall sensor is present here. Let me show you. As you can see, these are wires of the Hall sensor, and these wires are UVW connections through which the motor works. So let me place it on the table and then open it to show you how you can test it. First, unscrew all the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 bolts, then, it will come out, and when it comes out, disconnect the connectors. In this way, the motor will get free. I have opened it, and the rotor is very simple. As you can see, these are magnets over here, and they are permanent magnets that help in the motion of the rotor. This is the stator, and it seems like this. 36 coils are installed on the stator and made in the form of three-phase or generated the three-phase. As you can see, UVW connections over here, and a Hall sensor is installed over here. The Hall sensor is used when the rotor rotates. There are cuts inside the rotor's magnets, so the Hall sensor detects the motion, direction, and speed. And through this, it knows whether the rotor rotates anti-clockwise or clockwise. So let's open the Hall sensor and learn how to test it. Now, with the help of a flat screwdriver, push the lock of the Hall sensor upward, and as you can see, it has come out easily. There is no such issue. As you can see, I have set the multimeter and then attached the alligator probes with the U, V, and W pins. I am connecting the black probes with the U pin, and the red probe with the next pin at any other point. The value on the multimeter's display is 7.9 ohms. All the wiring combinations should have the same value. If the values are high, low, or zero, then, in that case, I will test the motor. Now I will test the motor's next terminals, as we are getting the same values on these terminals. Which means that the motor is absolutely fine. Next, the body short test is also important. Always test the short circuit. For any reason, if the motor gets faulty, you must test the short circuit with all the coils, as it has a plastic body. All 36 coils are separate from each other, so it is important to check all the coils with all the U, V, and W terminals one by one. If any one coil is short-circuited, so it means that the motor is short-circuited, and the time has come to change the motor or repair the motor. This is the way of testing the direct drive motor. The next thing I will test is the Hall sensor. At the first two pins of the Hall sensor, we should get positive 15 volts, which means it is fine. The first pin is 15 volts pin, and the second pin is the ground pin, and this is Hall A, and this is Hall B, which means two sensors are present here, which is sensor A and sensor B. So you have to check the 15 volt or common pin, and with the common pin, check what values we get on the two sensors on the multimeter, let me tell you. Now attach the red probe to the common or 15 volt pin. The next black probe on the left side will be attached to the Hall sensor B. As you can see, the multimeter is showing 10.45 kilo ohms. The value ranges from 5 to 15 kilo ohms, and if that value increases from 15 kilo ohms, and if the value is less than 5 kilo ohms still, the sensor will consider faulty. Next, we'll take out the pin and put it in pin number 2, which means sensor number 2 or Hall A sensor, and we should get the same value here. As you can see, the multimeter displays the same 10.03 kilo ohms value, and there is no such issue. While testing the sensors, if the value is more than 15 kilo ohms or less than 5 kilo ohms, as I told you before, then the time will be to change the sensor or repair it. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch the next videos, and subscribe. It's free.